Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about torquing springs, and it's not really something I use. I have used it maybe a handful of times in the last 20 years. Why? Because I've never found that I need them, because if you treatment plan properly, put your brackets on properly, work up the wire sequence properly without skipping steps, you don't need them. And of course, you can't buy cheap brackets. It's more of a thing with cheap brackets, I would say. If you have properly torqued brackets, if you're using brackets that don't have proper torque built in them or they're made someplace that are super cheap, then yeah, you might need them. So hopefully you're not using cheap brackets. But you know, your regular MBT, Roth, anything like that, you should not be using these if you're doing this right. But I'm gonna talk about them anyways. And we're gonna talk a little bit more about labial, root torque versus palatal or lingual root torque. I actually have other videos on that. So you wanna, this will definitely build on those. I'm gonna assume you've already watched my torque videos. So if you wanna watch those first, please do. Go to my YouTube channel, Straight Smile Solutions. You can use the little search feature. It looks like a magnifying glass, put in the word torque and my video or videos should pop up. Can't remember how many I have. But let's talk about that. And so many people put them on backwards. So I just wanted to go over what exactly they do. There are some how-to videos out there. I don't make too many how-to videos because they're very time consuming. And yeah, there's already ones out there on the internet, so you don't need them. I more talk about the why behind things. So that's my style. But anyways, so in this situation, and let's go over it again, you have to work up the wire sequence properly. You have to fully, if you do the right steps in the right order and you're not doing dumb things like using power chain on 18 Nitai, you know, you really shouldn't have torquing issues because the brackets do their job when you do things properly, right? And like I said, you got to buy high quality brackets. But let's say you got to the point where you're in like, okay, let's assume we're in 022 slot. You're in 1925 Nitai maybe, and or even 1925 steel, and you feel like you're 2-2 or your teeth 7-10 for those Americans out there. You feel like they need some, one or more of them. Maybe these two teeth were kind of palatal at one point. They were an anterior crossbite. They were kind of palatal. They were behind. We had jumped the crossbite with the wires, but we don't feel like there's enough root torque. It looks kind of funny. And this is not a great picture because the torque is fine, right? So, but you know, you've seen those situations. It happens more, I think, with laterals or even canines where they were maybe blocked out and then the root was kind of palatal. And then we drag the crown forward and then we're waiting for the root to upright and we just want to speed that up. That's the situation where you'd put your torquing springs on like this with the U going down, okay? With the loop facing down, like almost like, I think of this like an arrow. So if you do this, the root is going to move, I say buccal, but labial, okay? That's gonna push the root labial. It's just gonna help to enhance the movement of it. You know, if you needed to speed things up or something like that. If you flipped it around and made it like this and like this, that would do the opposite. That would be for the situation where maybe you had like a class two, div two kind of laterals or centrals or something like that. And they were crazy upright to begin with. And we wanted to make the root look more palatal. Then you would flip it this way, you pointing up. And the opposite on the bottom, you can do the same thing, right? You pointing down is gonna make the root go more lingual. You pointing up is for that other situation. So again, can't say this enough times, proper treatment planning, proper wire sequence, not rushing your wires, not using power chain on light wires, letting the wires fully express, making sure your teeth are fully engaged and the wire is not deflected at all before you move up the wire sequence. If you do things properly, you will not need torquing springs. But they're pretty cheap ways if you wanted to try them. They're there. Patients hate them, by the way. So I just thought I'd point, they think they're ugly. I think this kind of stuff kind of flies better maybe 20, 30, 40 years ago when, you know, before braces were, you know, now braces are so streamlined and so beautiful and small and efficient and the slots are really well made and milled and or 3D printed and they're just accurate. So you shouldn't need these. This was like more in the olden days where either you had your edgewise and you were putting in bends like Tweed Mechanics or you had just some really junky brackets, cheap brackets from other countries and you were just trying to accelerate things around. But Okay, now you know what a torquing spring does. Thank you.